messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. And to believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. And to believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Dear viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome to episode number 9 from the series Tawheed First. If you have missed the first 8 episodes of the series, we're talking about the aqeedah, the beliefs of a Muslim, the correct beliefs of a Muslim, the right beliefs of a Muslim, which you must possess in your heart in order for your actions to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, your salah, your zakah, your fasting, your hajj, whatever of righteous deeds you do, its acceptance depends upon the soundness of your beliefs. Yes, the series is called Tawheed First, but we decided to embark on introducing the broader subject where Tawheed falls in. And the broader subject is called Aqeedah, which is beliefs. Believe in Allah, angels, books, messengers, day of resurrection, and Qadr, the 6 pillars of Iman. Yes, the first of them is the belief in Allah, which is Tawheed. That is why we said Tawheed first. But we should spend some time explaining at least what this Aqeedah is all about. In this episode, dear viewers, and possibly the next 2 episodes, I want to answer a question which really should be asked to any Muslim. Tell me what you believe. Ideally, tell me what you believe. Of course, it is almost impossible for a person to share all his beliefs all at once in details, but the purpose or the objective behind this episode is to give you highlights, each one point, or each of the points which I will make, or each of these highlights requires actually a whole series to explain. But I think it's important that you learn the highlights from your aqeedah. And by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we prepared for you a slideshow which will help you keep up with me. We called it Highlights from the Aqeedah, and this is part 1, of course, and this is our episode number 9. Okay, let's look at the first bullet. The first item in your aqeedah is the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comprises 4 things. Believing in the existence of the divine essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in His Lordship, believing in His names and attributes, and believing in His rights upon us, that we must single out our actions to Him. We devote what we do to Him and not to rivals, not to partners. And this is, bifadlillah, will be the next item in this series. That is why we called it Tawheed first. Ifradullah, Tawheedullah, Ifradullah biasmaihi wa sifatihi wa af'alihi wa huquqihi. That you single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His actions, actions of Lordship. He is the only creator. He is the sovereign. He is the disposer, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who gives you life. He is the one who takes it away from you. He is the one who benefits you. If you want to talk about Allah, the Lord, hear what Ibrahim alayhi salam said when he addressed his people. He said the following to them.
أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْبُدُونَ أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمُ الْأَقْدَمُونَ فَإِنَّهُمْ عَدُوٌّ لِي إِلَّا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ
All what you worship beside Allah are my enemies, except the Lord of all that exist. Rabbahu. Who's that, ya Ibrahim?
الذي خلقني فهو يهدين والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين والذي يميتني ثم يحيين والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين
The one who created me and guides me, the one who gives me water to drink, the one who gives me food to eat, and when I get sick, He gives me cure, and the one who will take that life away from me, He will cause me to die, and He will resurrect me, and I am hoping He will forgive me in the day of resurrection. That is the Lordship, singling out Allah to be the Lord. Also, singling out Allah once it comes to His names and attributes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has beautiful names and perfect attributes.
وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ لَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى قُلْ ادْعُوا اللَّهَ أَوْ ادْعُوا الرَّحْمَنَ أَيَّمَّا تَدْعُوا فَلَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى
All these are verses from the Quran which says that Allah has the perfect names, the perfect attributes. So you single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His Lordship, in His names and attributes. And if this is the Creator, the one who created you, the one who takes care of you, the one who provides for you, the one who given you the life that you have, the one who gives you the rizq, the provision, the one who is in control of your life, why do you go and worship someone else in association with Him? Then you single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your actions. Right away, you raise your hand and say, I will submit to you, Ya Rabb, sincerely, Ya Rabb, and I will say this,
قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ
My salah, my sacrifice, my rituals, my life, my death is for Allah with no partners. And this is the right of Allah upon you. Don't be hasty, inshallah, the second half of the series is about this. That's why we called it Tawheed first. You see, we're talking about the highlights of the Aqeedah. The first thing that comes to you is Tawheedullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ifradullah, singling out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it comes to His divine essence, names, attributes, actions of Lordship. And as a result of this, you single Him out in your actions as well. Well, the second bullet here, look at that, believe in the angels. This is the second piece of your aqeedah. We believe that they do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are constantly praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We were told some of their names in the Quran and in the Sunnah, such as Jibreel alayhi salam, Mikael, and Israfil. We'll give some examples from the Quran, the verses from the Quran. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them,
لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون.
They do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding what He commands them, and they do what they are commanded to do. They praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, all the time. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the human,
فإن استكبروا فالذين عند ربك يسبحون له بالليل والنهار وهم لا يسأمون.
If the human beings are arrogant to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise Him every day and every night, all day and all night, and they do not get bored from that. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we were told about the greatness also of their creation.
الحمد لله فاطر السماوات والأرض جاعل الملائكة رسلا جاعل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاث ورباع يزيد في الخلق ما يشاء إن الله على كل شيء قدير.
All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who fashioned the heavens and the earth, and He made the angels messengers. And they have two wings, three wings, and more. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so Jibreel alayhi salam, he has 600 wings. Also, dear viewers, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described other angels like the bearers of the throne. A huge, huge body that they have. Dear viewers, we know that also some of their names were revealed to us in the Quran, like Jibreel and Mikael.
قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًّا لِلَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالَ.
Right here, Allah mentioned that in Surah Al-Baqarah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri fi Mustadrak al-Hakim, which has a different wording, he named the angel who hold the horn to be Israfil. I just want to remind you that we need to refrain from calling angels with names that was not were not revealed to us in the Quran and Sunnah. Very famous mistake amongst a lot of the people who deliver sermon, they refer to the angel of death to be Azrael. Never been mentioned any place. Is called the angel of death. Let's take a short break. Come back and learn a little bit more about your aqeedah, dear viewers. Don't go away. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
It is belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scripture.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear viewers, welcome back. Highlights from your aqeedah, things that you must memorize. And I love it if you can get your children to memorize this stuff. Yani not memorize it word by word, is not Quran, but at least the meanings. When you ask him to, what is Tawheed is, right here. Okay, what is believing the angels? Tell me a sentence or two about believing the angels. Tell me a sentence or two about believe in the books. And this is the third bullet that we have. Al-Kutub. We believe, brothers and sisters in Islam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed books to the nations before us. And we have some of their names, like the Torah, At-Tawrah, like Al-Zabur, the Psalms of Dawood alayhi salam, and like the Gospel. And we also have something called Suhuf Ibrahim wa Musa. We believe in the existence of these books. But with that comes another element that we must believe, that these books, the hands of humans got to it. Listen, we are not saying that because of that. It's actually, if you investigate the matter, you will find out that these books are distorted. But we do not reject every single thing in these books. They are still possessing some of the right messages. But which is which and which is what? That is why we say the Quran takes the ultimate authority over it.
وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ.
Right here, the Quran takes the authority over it. I really feel disgusted when I say that. How in the world you read in the Old Testament that Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, after concluding his message almost, he ends up sleeping with his daughters, getting drunk? Do you think this is from Allah? Impossible. Impossible. How in the world would you read in the Old Testament similar to that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this to us in the Quran, that they wrote a lot of the things, the people of the book, and they said it's from Allah.
فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ لِيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا فَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا كَتَبَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ.
Woe, hail to those who write things and they say it's from Allah in order to earn some of worldly gains. We believe that. There is nothing personal. We believe that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the children of Israel the nature of the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam once it comes to the books.
يا أهل الكتاب قد جاءكم رسولنا يبين لكم كثيرا مما كنتم تخفون من الكتاب ويعفو عن كثير.
Oh, our messenger came to show you a lot of the things that you used to conceal from your books, and he admits some. Okay, let's move to another item here. Very important. We must believe that the messengers and the prophets are the best of people. Remember, why are we saying this? Because we have people in the ummah, and again, nothing personal. We have the extreme Sufis. They believe الولي مقام الولي مقام الولي في برزخ فوق النبي ودون الرسول. The wali with them is higher in status than the Prophet. Listen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose those individuals from the human race in order to convey his message.
Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalatahu.
Allah knows best who qualifies to convey his message. Now you come in as a human being and you produce another human being and you say this is better than the Prophet, so the choice of Allah is lower than the choice of the human beings. طيب, we have also the Rawafid, those who reject the leadership of Abu Bakr, Umar and Uthman, and they curse the companions. Nothing is personal. We're just explaining to the people what is going on. They believe the imams are better than the prophets. You as a Muslim must believe that the best of people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen to convey his message are the messengers and the prophets, and no one is above them. Also, we believe that messengers are infallible once it comes to conveying the message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose people to convey his message. They are infallible. They are not going to conceal. They are not going to twist. They are not going to change the revelation in order to fit the desire of people. Also, we believe that no more revelation after the Prophet. Why are we saying this? This stuff, If you believe in this and you make it firm in your heart without any taint of doubt, you rest. You see, just this aqeedah, just this piece of belief. Okay, we have Baha'i who say that Baha'iyya, Baha'ullah, there is Baha'ullah, somebody who came after the Masih. And we have Qadianiyya, they believe otherwise. They believe that there was revelations, there were messengers after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the messenger to be the seal of all the prophets.
مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ.
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is not the father of any of you, but he is the messenger of Allah and the seal, the final messenger, the final messenger. And this is something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also confirms, that أنا خاتم الرسل, أنا خاتم النبيين. I was given 6 things that no other messenger was given, and one of them that I was the seal of them. Now you have a belief now. So every day we get people who claim that they are prophets. Every day I get people, I'm a prophet, I'm Jesus, I'm this, and well, there is something here that may tackle you. What about the second coming of Isa? Prophet Isa will come down as a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What he is supposed to do is already revealed in the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hasn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the 6 things that he will do? يوشك أن ينزل فيكم ابن مريم, الحديث البخاري ومسلم. The son of Maryam is about to descend amongst you, and he will do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six things. Study them. Look at them. Look at them. Have that belief. We believe in the day of resurrection. And with the belief in the day of resurrection comes in the belief in the minor signs of the day of resurrection, the major signs of the day of resurrection, and all the life in the grave. We believe in all of that. We believe in the resurrection. We believe in what is going to happen. The gathering, the reckoning, the 70,000 and more who will enter Jannah without reckoning and punishment, the scale, the bond, the sirat, and all of this, and the end, Jannah or Nar. I presented this in a whole series called The Inevitable Journey. Go back and watch it. I enjoyed doing it. We believe in al-Qadr. We believe in al-Qadr. And the Qadr comprises four pillars. Ilmullah, Allah knew everything. Then he wrote it. When? 50,000 years before he created the heavens and the earth. Then he willed it. Then he created us to implement this. We believe that the prophets will intercede for us in the day of resurrection. We believe that the messengers and the prophets will intercede for their people. We believe in the karamat, people who are followers of the Quran and the Sunnah. They have something called supernatural things happen at their hands, but they must be righteous. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you see a man walking in water, flying in the air, and he does not have the Quran and Sunnah, the proper aqidah, huwa zindiq, he is not even a Muslim. Jinni are helping him. And remember, the Antichrist, the biggest sorcerer, who will emerge into the face of this earth, by the way, he will have a lot of supernatural powers. Like we said, we must single out Allah in his actions and single your actions to him. Don't miss the next episode of Tawheed First, as we will explore more highlights of that beautiful, beautiful aqeedah that you have. Wallahi, you have the most beautiful aqeedah in the whole earth. It's from Allah. Till then, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Faith is belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there is no God but Allah, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there is no God but Allah. Belief in Allah and and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. And to believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection, there is no God but Allah.